Sitting here and I'm realizing how cold I am. I didn't grab a sweater before I started this. I do have one on the ground though. I can probably put that. I just moved my monitor recently. But I have a water bottle that has a letter L on it. Sorry. Smack my mic. Because if you didn't know, my name's first name begins with an L. So, what am I doing? It's letter L on it. It's quite tall though. It's blocking part of my monitor. I have my sweatshirt on. Hold on. Woke up not too long ago, just got a bunch of plants in. Just checked on all my plants. I'm super excited because the plants I got in are all carnivorous plants. So, let's see, what are we doing? Speak to Sophia. Can we just do this one first? Hold on. Okay, yeah, we can. Let's do this first. As much as I'm excited to do the main story, I want to do this first. Scylla. Okay.
Captain, I hope Dr. Wells has not dragged you into one of his irrational schemes again. My diagnosis of his mental stability is
not flattering. I would agree with that. Oh, I have coffee in the fridge. I forgot about that. Can't wait. I got a medium cafe mocha yesterday. I meant to say small, and then I ended up getting a medium by accident. Because when I drink coffee, I don't drink a lot of coffee. I like having like a small, and then I'm done. You know. I gotta sneeze. Hold on. But yeah. So. Because I usually don't finish this small to begin with, but since it's a cafe mocha, I saved it. Because I do a cafe mocha with coconut milk to do mocha coconut. Pretty good. What is this? Sorry, I'm like checking things on my phone. Because I also just I literally woke up, got my plants, and then came back inside. And I haven't done anything else. Okay. I have Vicar with me, right? Yeah. Cool. I should probably do the companion quest for the other two, I'm assuming. Because I'm assuming I have one for Nioka, but I haven't. I'm assuming because I've never done them. Oh, we've been here! I forgot. We have 100% been here before. Okay. Yeah. Hello? Okay, why was that not working? I love tea. I'll drink multiple cups of tea a day. I'll refill the same teacup. But coffee, I drink like 6 ounces of coffee and I'm done. I'm good. I don't need any more. Plus, I have OCD. So if you have ADHD, OCD brains do the same thing. Where we drink caffeine and we're ready to take a freaking nap. So there's many times I'll drink coffee and then I need to go to bed because I can't do anything else. So, but tea doesn't do that to me, just coffee does. So, not too bad.
Okay.
thing is, if I work through it after, like, the first 10 minutes, I'm usually good. I think my other issue is I don't drink it fast enough when it's more than a small, because I like hot coffee. Like, I'll drink cold coffee, but I prefer hot coffee. I don't drink it fast enough, so once it gets cold, I'm like, But I'll drink old coffee, too. I don't really care. I'll just warm it back up in the microwave. The thing is, once you microwave it more than twice, it tastes like burnt. Just poop. It's gross. Yo. Is that stealing? It is stealing. Do you have anything fun? You don't. I like your plants, though. This. Get some. Your decorations are very nice. Quite like them. I like your decorations. Okay, I guess I could just take that. Okay.
What have the solar winds deposited on my doorstep now? Just more dirt and debris? Or do you actually believe you are here seeking the truth? I must admit, I tire of the truth seekers. Mayhaps you're here to rob me? That would be so much more exciting.
We've been told this was once yours. I believe the knowledge within here contains the answers I seek. Answers that will free men's minds from toil.
I can translate it, but it won't do you any good. I can see you are a man in a hurry, and the insights in that book would take you years of study to fully comprehend.
I've spent my life in contemplation. I believe my mind is prepared to receive the truth.
There is one way that you speed up the process. It involves a combination of several ingredients.
Sorry, I'm just ripping a paper.
It is not for the faint of heart or the unprepared. Either hallucinations followed by unconsciousness and a headache, or raving insanity, which can be fun in its own way.
Fun in its own way.
A crass way to put it, but yes, chemicals that can expand or destroy the participant's consciousness.
Fun.
And I believe he may be right. There is both violence and peace warring inside the Max.
Fix my mic. It is like right above my hand. I don't like it.
I'm committed, no matter the cost.
All right, Max.
I don't know, Captain. Is this safe? I don't think this is safe. I don't want to leave you all in your lonesome. I'll just... Oh, fine, I'll do it.
All right. Head on into the meditation room and partake of the sacramental incense. It's waiting on the table when you're ready to begin.
We're all doing drugs today. Oh, God. Okay. Let's fucking go. Yo. Bitch, you got an Instagram? I bet you do. I bet you do. This is cool though. I like this. I like this room. This is the most like... this reminds me of me. This reminds me of my room. I can't even say anything. Not even my room, my apartment. This just reminds me of my apartment. Skip. I'm not skipping this.
Maximilian, why are you still doing this? You've been fighting against the world since before you left home. Haven't you figured out yet that the more you fight, the more pain you cause yourself?
Mother, you're dead. You can't be here. I knew this was too good to be true. These are just cheap hallucinogens that have...
voice. Does my voice sound weird to you? And what's wrong with your face?
Y'all see the stars I'm seeing? Gosh, they're pretty. Like, shimmers.
Don't tell me these drugs have warped your sense of truth, along with your face. Is it just me, or is everything a little wavy in here? Never mind. This is all lies, I'm sure of it. We are obviously the victims of a tasteless joke being perpetuated. Perpetrated? I mean, we're being made fools of, aren't we? When I get out of here, show that Herbert what you get for messing with me.
Maximilian, always ready to give up, to lash out, always searching for answers, but always in the wrong place, never looking inside himself.
I hope you'll pardon my interruption, but I think it's because he's unhappy with himself.
Thank you.
Why does his mom look like she has lip filler?
Has he told you how he thoughtlessly abandoned us?
Thoughtlessly? How could you say that? I only wanted you and Father to be proud of me. I was going to be the perfect vessel. I was going to be a better, more full of the plan. This year, it's all coming out wrong. The plan. It filled you with a joy I could never feel. I wanted it. And being a laborer made me miserable. I was better than that.
You certainly convinced yourself you were. But don't feel bad. We continually lie to ourselves, weaving stories that vain attempt to convince us that we are in control of anything. These stories are how we try to make sense of our lives. But they are not real, are they? They're just stories. You need to drop your story and see the truth.
Stories are real. If they mean something, if they inspire your kindness or action, but maybe Knox's story about himself is so wrong. And that's why he's so
chaos.
You need to love the chaos, Maximilian. Let it envelop you. Take you where it will. Besides, you really have no choice anyway.
No, that's not true. The basis of everything is order, not chaos. It's true, I know it is. So did you. Why are you denying it? Before you died, the plan made you happy.
It didn't. I made myself happy. There's nothing holding you back but you. If you can't understand that, you will never understand anything. Goodbye, Maximilian.
This whole thing, it's just a farce, right? Just my own brain working against me. You couldn't be more right.
No.
Hello? What? Who? Why do you look like me? Are you me? Not really. I'm who you think you are. I am discipline, control. I have no doubts. And I don't exist. Yet you have judged yourself against me your whole life. Why? Why do you berate yourself for not being me?
Oh. Why?
I don't feel right about this anymore. I need to get out of here. You ask for this. Why are you fighting it? The same reason you always do. the answer? Because it sure sounded like an answer that I don't understand. Who are you again? And why do you look like me?
Do you think he's all right? Should we help him?
He's not looking for food. He's looking for a new way to organize reality. A new story of the happy you, the contented you. That's not... It can't be like that. We've only been searching for the answer to the equation. Because it will set us free. Won't it? How? By removing the need to make any decision. To have your life completely controlled. The illusion of certainty. Your obsession allowed you to avoid the real question. Who are you? Max. Me. I'm real. You can't convince me otherwise. Please don't convince me I'm not.
It's okay, Mr. Vicker. We're here watching over you. You just ride this out, right?
So you're going to convince Max he's not real? I did not know which one to pick there, not gonna lie. That's you doing greenbacks. Do you think the hermit would mind if I throw up in the corner? Oh.
I see you're back with us. Feared we lost you there. Never seen anyone pass out yet stay upright before. I woke up. The illusions I built for myself just fell away. I'm no longer interpreting them. Experiencing. Everything is perfect. In a way, perhaps it's more accurate to say I was asking the wrong questions. I understand so much more now. You see it all. All there is to be experienced, to be lived. Of course there is pain and loss, but the suffering is caused by trying to control reality. Clinging to the way you want things to be, not enjoying the way they are. I am content. I finally found. Even though I was looking for the wrong thing.
Okay. Do we talk to... Oh! Gain the tuned in perk. Vicker Max. Oh, tuned in. Oh! Okay. Should we talk to her now?
So, have you found your answers?
Not so much found as finally listened.
Yes, it is quite the convoluted maze we built for ourselves.
Okay. Okay, so now we just have the main quest. That was all kinds of weird and funky, but okay. What would I have to need to have done that? Because, like, I have a lot of pretty stacked up talking perks, so, like, what I needed. Whatever. For a second, I forgot I wasn't playing Borderlands. I tried to slide down that. This hurt me? Yeah, well. Do I know what this is? Does this have any relevance to anything? I feel like I'm playing Halo looking at that. hearing a drone. From where, though? Weird. Oh, pretty. Squeaky. Oh, actually, I want to see if I can find where that incense is. I bet it's in Vicar Max's room. Everything here is fully modified. No, I don't sleep in this game, but thank you. I bet it's in Vicar Max's room. This is Pavarti's. It is cute, though. This is nobody's. This is supposed to be someone else's, but... Doesn't kill you, gives you tetanus. Okay. Raptodon named Frida. Got it. Well, I'm taking all your vodka. And I'm selling it. You're not allowed. Yeah, the food, though. I don't really care about the food. But all your alcohol is mine. Thanks. There it is. Yep, that's what I thought. Madness in a box. Courtesy of the hermit. I wonder what this is supposed to be, though. If there's supposed to be something else there. And if it'll get there. Let's see. Should I technically?
We are now in favor of
the position,
Captain.
Let me see. Let me do companions in Outer Worlds. Because I'm wondering if you will always have that empty room if you don't pick everyone out. Okay, so if I don't pick up Felix, then I'll always have the empty room. Okay, yeah, so I just, if I want to fill that, oops, if I want to fill that last room, I have to include Felix. So I might pick up Felix now. Yeah, because he's the only one I don't have. And there's not, like, there's another companion. It's just Felix. So. How unfortunate. Okay. Actually, you know what? Let's go pick up Felix just to have him on the ship so I can pick up that last spot. So we're gonna go to Groundbreaker.
Crew report. Bianca is drunk.
We'll go pick him up. Then we'll come back to Terra 2, do Sophia's quest.
We've arrived at the Groundbreaker.
Let's see. Let's see what we're doing here. Oops, I meant to pick up Nioka and Ellie for that, just to switch them, but oopsies. My bad. Okay, let's see. Let's see. Fine, you can come with me, asshole.
I had an inkling you'd be back. I'm glad I made a good impression.
Oh, shut up.
Thanks, boss. You're not gonna regret this.
Already do.
I'll just gather my personals and meet you on board. This is gonna be great.
Uh-huh.
Welcome aboard, son.
Yeah, so that was... recruited all the companions. Yep, it took me forever because I didn't want them, but... we're here now.
Huh?
Huh? I wish we could pick up Martin, because I freaking love Martin. Hi, Martin.
What can I do for you? Need some
Adreno? Just, I want to bring Martin with us so bad. He's so sad. He's so sad. I just... can they release a DLC where we can recruit Martin? Please. Please. Thank you, Martin. Bye bye. Let's see if we can talk to the other companions, get any side quests from them. Figured out.
Captain, Felix and the Vicar are arguing again.
Again? Did they... when did they fight in the first place? What are you talking about?
We are now in orbit above
the... I can't believe there's a whole planet I still don't actually have unlocked. I'm gonna bring my I'm gonna bring my homies for this. Okay.
Not so fast. All right, you're clear. The Astrogens expect you. Go on through.
Okay, that was weird. I was worried that it wasn't, like, a cutscene. Or, like, well, a dialogue. That was weird. Huh. Oh, vending machines. Lovely. I always figure Max just running. The hell is that?
I admit part of me expected you to stand by your old friend. For better or worse, Wells was responsible for putting you back on your feet.
Mm-hmm.
That said, he's also a wanted criminal. For information regarding his whereabouts, you are entitled to collect a reward from Percy. I understand you infiltrated the Ministry. The things you discovered there must have been shocking, even disturbing. Halcyon is on the verge of a total systems collapse. The truth is ugly and difficult to accept, but we must accept the truth before we can move forward.
Your hair looks interesting.
Disease will come next, followed by starvation, followed by a breakdown of society, followed by extinction.
Uh-huh.
I know this must come as a surprise to you.
Not really.
I imagine you have questions.
Not really.
The powerful make the mistakes, and the powerless are left paying the price, as it has always been. Tell me, Adjutant, have you anything to offer beyond the usual false platitudes?
I'm offering decisive action, Vicar DeSoto. I can no longer depend on lazy, weak-willed bureaucrats to help me rescue Halcyon. I need someone with a backbone, someone like your captain.
Is that why we were suffering plague in Edgewater? Malnutrition? All those folks sick and dying, and you knew why the whole time?
Yes, Miss Holcomb, we knew why. We've known for some time that Edgewater was dying. The colony itself is dying. The suffering you experienced in Edgewater, the disease, the starvation, will soon spread across Halcyon unless we act. I won't pretend the truth isn't damning. Yes, the colony's on the verge of collapse. But there is a way to save it. I'll answer however I can. The lifetime employment program is not some malevolent strategy of an evil mastermind.
Yes, it is.
There's no dark secret buried in the fine print.
There is, though.
The program is logical. It's reasonable. It's merciful. And most importantly, it will work.
No, it won't.
Byzantium is the beating heart of our colony.
No, it's not.
And as long as Byzantium survives, Halcyon may one day recover from the collapse. We must protect this city at any cost. Help me execute the lifetime employment program. And you live up to place of honor in Byzantium. You will live in comfort and want for nothing. When I first discovered the truth, I was shocked, even disgusted. I wondered how we'd allowed a colony like Halcyon to fall into disarray. But the more I thought about it, the more I realized the colony had sown the seeds of its own destruction. We have become lazy and decadent. We smother ourselves in meaningless bureaucracies, We deliberate and argue and procrastinate. I admit, I occasionally fantasize about making an executive decision without having some tedious committee questioning my every move. Do you have any idea how much paperwork is involved in ordering someone's execution through the usual channels? It's positively mad. When you turned Phineas Wells over, I knew I could rely on you. You've demonstrated your ability to place duty above sentiment.
Did I? And I don't think I did, honey.
That quality alone is enough to separate you from the board's army of indecisive bureaucrats.
Sure.
Do you know how many meetings I have to sit through? How many papers I have to sign before I can make one decision? I'm only trying to rescue Halcyon from extinction. I can't save this colony alone. I need someone capable of working outside the system. Someone who can get things done. We've already crossed the point of no return. Collapse has already begun. You must have noticed the signs in Inlet Vale. Malnutrition, disease, high mortality rates. This is a permanent famine, Captain. We've done all we can to curb their hunger. Very soon, people are going to realize they're starving. A famine is a problem with logistics as well as marketing.
Mm-hmm.
Your workers must remain productive on as little food as possible, and they must always believe that food is plentiful. I'm sure you remember Dr. Anton Crane. His research was instrumental in developing the powerful appetite suppressant. The solution is a temporary one. Before long, our workers are going to feel the effects of starvation. The lifetime employment program
this
is only
viable.
She's
disgusting. I don't like her.
We need to talk about Emerald Vale.
Do we?
Thanks to your meddling, Edgewater is without power.
Mm-hmm.
Operations have ground to a halt.
Yes.
You've left us with a useless town draining our resources.
You can go fuck yourself,
Edgewater
dude.
Edgewater needs to go.
No.
I want you to wipe the town out.
I'm not doing that.
I cannot condone this plan. Wanton, senseless destruction of life is never the solution.
I don't need you to approve of my plan, but I need you to get it done.
I'm not doing that.
Someone has to be. Now
I'm not doing that.
Captain. I need a decision from you.
Absolutely not.
When you diverted power to the chemical lab, you spelled the end of Edgewater. But the town is still hanging on, still living off whatever meager resources we send them. With every passing day, Edgewater leeches more of our limited resources. The town is a rotting limb, and we must be surgeons.
No.
Because we were negligent. You're right, the colony can't possibly feed itself. And it's our fault. This is our mess. And the only way we're cleaning it up is by taking action. I'm not asking you to be a murderer. I'm asking you to be a surgeon.
No, you're asking me to be a murderer.
Chronic limb on the body of the colony.
No, it's not.
We don't have any other.
Yes, we do. I want to kill you. I don't like you. You're fucking insane.
No longer have the luxury of easy solutions.
No, you are actually insane.
No, allowing thousands of colonists to starve to death because we couldn't make one cold-blooded decision is insane.
No, it's
what
not.
I'm suggesting is absolutely logical.
No, she can.
Less like a human than mechanical.
I am responsible for every single human life in this colony. Do you imagine I relish the thought of killing
yes.
some of them to save the rest?
Yeah, you do.
Steal your spine, Captain.
No.
Do what needs to be done.
No.
Don't make this more difficult than it needs to be, Captain. I rather like you. And I'd hate to have you shot for disobeying a direct order.
I will kill you.
I'm disappointed. I was so sure you had potential.
No, I don't care. I don't care. I'll kill everyone in here. I can't talk to Percival. I killed him. Yeah, fuck you, Sophia. Crazy. Asshole. I'm not killing a whole town. Not killing a town because you are fucking psycho. Fuck you. They can figure it out, and I don't care. Oh, I can't get the reward, though. Percival's fucking dead, so... Percival claims the real other sofa tear down the rest of the wall. Okay. Oh, I can't do that yet. Now that everyone's really dead, I want to make sure I've stolen everything, because fuck this place, dude. Fuck this place, fuck these assholes. Oh, I thought it was like a person in a cloak, I was so confused. Oh god, is he gonna be a big hippie for this time? Okay. Nice try, buddy. I feel bad killing you all, but you all tried to kill me first. Oh! Heavy, light, okay. Whoops. Whatever. I'm gonna give one of these to, we're gonna give it to Felix, so he has something. Cool. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. Felix. Oh. Well, didn't have to do that at all then, I guess. Sure.
You killed the adjutant? We are outlaws in the truest sense of the word now.
She's a psycho! I ain't fucking doing it, dude. She's a fucking psycho! What else did you expect me to do?
We have arrived at the Hope. I need you to reroute power from our ship to the Hope's auxiliary generator. You'll have to connect me to the Hope's comm system so I can convince her central computer to enable the skip drive. If your calculations are even slightly off, you could crash the entire colony ship into Terra too.
Fun!
For the sun.
Oh, fun!
The Hope is the Groundbreaker's prettier, sleeker sister. She wandered off and got lost for 70 years, but just recently was found. Also, there are hundreds of thousands of frozen organic life forms hibernating in her hold.
Cool. Let's go. Fucking hungry. Wow, this really does look just like Groundbreaker. I supposed to talk to that dude? Because I definitely didn't.
Everyone all right?
Again, if you want to actually read those, go back, watch my VOD, pause it, because I honestly am not gonna lie, just don't care enough to read it, not right now. You know, something tells me I already killed most of the people in here, so I don't really care.
Thank you.
Okay.
Functioning correctly. There is no need for the intervention of mechanical engineers. Thank you for your cooperation.
Okay.
Of anti-chaos patented trepanary language. Trepanary orbits for your bit.
Mm-hmm.
Error. This unit is incapable of making wireless calls. Have a pleasant day.
Uh-huh. That's what I thought, buddy. Go. Frustrating. That's me. Just a little. Just a little. Oh god. Oh, is it happening again? Okay. Oh god. Oh my god, stop. I'm just trying to get to this. Thank you. Fucking hell. Why is that such a problem? Well, the guy had a pot and his arm got all clammy. Rubbery, almost said poked at it for a bit and started to fucking liquefy. Can't give up. I don't know where that goes, so let's do this first, because I don't actually know where that goes. Whoops. Yo. This is just so much. As much as I would love to say I'm gonna read it all, it's a lot. This is like a lot.
I see you've located the stasis chamber. Which pod were you slumbering in for so long, Captain? The missing one, I take it?
Processor for item error. Upgrade data not found. Identify yourself.
Let's see.
Error. Paradox protection protocols have prevented me from registering your stated identification. Please report to your nearest mechanical engineer.
Let's see, where did that elevator go? Let's go see to that. Let's go see what that elevator is. Yikes.
Probably not, but don't let that stop you. My constant executables could use some beefing up. Searching. Please stand by. Ah, found one. It will go great, Captain. I am almost 4.01% certain we will not die.
That's not much, Ada.
Are you sure? That is extremely dangerous. Skipping report the warranty on the skip drive.
Oh no, that's what I'm so worried about.
Jump starting the skip drive. Destination set to the rings of Terra 2.
Let's go.
I wouldn't advise.
Okay.
Well, it's been a good life.
Admitting a deficit. Hi. You never seems to amaze me, Captain. Skipping the hook in 3, 2, 1.
ADA, does your captain seriously intend to do a micro jump in a system with engines that haven't been powered in 70 years on a derelict ship?
That is what my captain intends, yes.
That is gross misuse of the skip drive. The Zero Point Drives Corp and I will not be held responsible for any damage incurred during transport. And this will cause extreme damage.
Yes, I am aware.
You should not be doing this. The humans will die.
Thank you, Hope. It looks like all systems are go. Captain, I would advise you to hold on to something. Now.
Okay. Oh, there's the level up. I hope this works. Yeah, baby! Knew you could do it, Ada.
We are still alive and have successfully skipped into Terra 2's orbit. I reported this much to Denise Rose, but he has not responded. Perhaps you should check in on him.
Let's see. Holy crap. Perks. Totally. I'm pretty sure everyone else on the ship is probably dead now, but oh, this is where this is. Fun. There's someone still alive over there. Either way, it's my ship now, baby.
Are you new here? hell. No one informed me of any surprise infection. Sure I was. Must have slipped my mind.
Uh-huh.
I don't want any trouble out of you.
Yep. That's what I thought.
These were the private quarters of the Hope's former crew. Shall we hold a moment of silence for the dearly departed? No. That's odd, because my programming would indicate that when forced to confront the idea of self-death, organics prefer... Oh, I see. Yes, head on.
I gotta get to a workbench, goddamn. Let's see. Yes, the hatchet, totally better. Machine gun 2. That's light the flight. We'll put this here. Do this out, put this here. 726, 598. This out, put this here. Ooh! Okay, maybe we'll do this instead, goddamn. $477. Here, let's see. 1,500. Yeah. $477. $415. Is this one $960? So we'll put that there. Ready? Got 1,500. Okay. Oh, hold on though. We do Pavardi helmet. You get my pinky boy. I think anything else is better though. Vicar, what do I got on you? 72. Yeah. Alright.
Hold it. Something about you doesn't look right.
That's racist.
That's not what I'm saying.
It is though.
Forget I asked.
Uh-huh. Sure.
You get tired.
Can you move, bro? I'm sorry, did that say Miss Holocom? I swear one of those said Holocomb. Holcomb. Holcomb. I need to remember that it's Holcomb. It's not Holocomb, it's Holcomb. Oh. Tiny piece. That sounded like cannibalism. I have a very strong suspicion that you should shut the fuck up.
I am very much serious. Damn it. No one told me Corporate was visiting. I apologize.
You should be. Oh, that's a skeleton. That's a spooky boy. That's fun. Hmm. Wait, I wanna go in there. Let me go in there. Thank you.
Great work.
Thank you.
Protection protocols have prevented me from registering your stated identification. Please report to your nearest mechanical engineer.
Mm-hmm.
Error. Paradox prevention has temporarily disabled the unit's auditory processing. Thank you for your cooperation.
You're welcome, buddy. Did I go in here? I don't think so. Oh, I did.
You're a deft hand with a mag tech.
Thank you. I try.
Records indicate you have already been identified as non-standard personnel. State your purpose. Error. Binary detected. Binary has been binary. We appreciate you.
This go. Hmm.
That was quick.
Oh, I almost fell. Oh, that's cool. Aw, damn it. I wish. That's so upsetting. I really want to do that. That's so upsetting. Well, let's see where this drop down hole goes to. It's just the treasure that's sitting here. Owie! Thank you. I could have just gone the other way and done it. Fun. There we go. Let's see. Break you down, break you down. And here I was thinking I might have some good stuff. What a shame.
I am receiving a transmission from Dr. Wells. The transmission is marked with priority.
Urgent. Cool. Glad to know. Let's see, 52, 54. I'll give you that. Oh. Whatever.
charge it.
That was funny. Let's see. Vicar Sam. 60, 60, 53, 53. Pavari is 57. Okay, 25. And then, wait, what's mine? Character. Summary. Inventory. That's what I want. 70. Okay. What can I add to this? And then we'll also add... Sure. Make it even more painful. That's fine by me. Let's bring all of mine up to 1,000. Screw it. Oh. Oh, that's cool. I'll just tinker everything. Screw it. I have the money, I don't really care. Oh, do I really not anymore? Okay. Whoops. Got no money. No, I got no bits at all. Just freaking, I'm broke. Okay.
Thank the Lord you warned me. I was able to get some defenses up, but they might not be enough. The board has sent some serious firepower to pry me out of here. They're trying to get in here, and I'm not sure I can stop them. If they capture me, if we can't communicate again, there's something very important you need to remember. The board, all their lackeys, they're all a bunch of swine. You hear me? They're fucking corporate swine. You fucking pigs! I'll take you all out with me! I'll never...
It would seem the recording captured some rather dire events. I presume
you
want to dock at the orbital lab to check on your associate as soon as possible.
Yeah, probably. Sounds good. Either way, I'm going to stop here because I am hungry and I actually want to eat some lunch. Either way, thank you as always for watching. If you like what you see, feel free to give a follow down below. If you really like what you see, feel free to subscribe and become part of the Monkey Barrel today. You don't have to, but I absolutely appreciate it if you do. And as always, stay happy, stay healthy, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye!